So John said, what about the abortion bill, Mr. President? I said, just frigging pay it.
The warriors of old went into battle waving bayonets and killing people, whereas far more effective but less well known were the warriors of old who went into battle shouting, are you absolutely sure you haven't left the gas on?
Money can often become worthless. I've always wiped my arse on mine, in preparation.
To me, I've always been a lovely guy, but for myself, I was never lovely enough. You understand what I'm saying? I felt that I had to find myself, and now I feel that I have. Don't get me wrong. Before, where I'd cut someone, now I'll just hurt them. You understand what I'm saying? I'm feeling good. I'm a lot more gentle now. I feel like I've found my own religion, which is Bullerism. Bullerism. But people, don't get me wrong, people are really trying to get into my little scene. I'm a lovely guy, but I can turn naughty. Let me show you something. I've got letters here from all over the world. I've got a letter here. Let me read you this. This is from that Dalai Lama. Buller, sweet as. Let me say this to you, Buller. You're like a flower that's budding. Let the bees come to you for your nectar of knowledge. Don't chase the bees. Now, I don't know if it exactly says that. I can't read the writing. But it says something along them lines.
Sometimes I don't know what to think.
But it wasn't just a fart. And, you see, because it had nowhere to go, and he was wearing quite a sort of tight, starched white collar and shirt, I'm not joking, honestly, a little bit of poo came out, and you could actually see it at the back of his neck. Good evening, Boris Yeltsin.
Throat really sore?
Really sore.
Eyes smarting?
Yes.
Blocked nose? Difficulty breathing?
Yes.
Aching, feverish body?
Yes.
Another sleepless night?
Yes.
You must be exhausted.
Yes, I am.
Moustache getting darker?
Yes.
Fat around your vital organs?
Yes, I suppose.
Worried that you don't know enough for your age?
Yes.
Massive rent with no access to a garden?
Yes.
Hips getting bigger?
Yes.
How about that nose? Still blocked?
Yes.
Only got two friends?
Yes.
Worried about how much one serving of vegetables amounts to?
Yes.
Dysfunctional relationship with your mother?
Yes.
Unresolved mounting grief?
Yes.
Constant fear of dying alone?
Yes, yes.
In a nursing home with some crippling, gnawing disease?
Yes.
Worried that everyone has a secret plan?
Yes.
Conspiring against you?
Yes.
That can't be helping your sore throat.
No, it's not.
How about the eyes? Are they still smarting?
Yes.
Hearing strangely accurate voices talking to you all the time?
Yes!
You know what you need, don't you?
What? What?
Oh, sorry, someone's come in. I've got to go.
No!
I've never been able to finish anything. Ever since I was a little boy. I've never been able to finish it. All my life, really. Always had the problem. It can get a bit enough. It can get a bit enough. It can get a bit enough. Not being able to finish.
I've really changed my ways. I'm a vegetarian.
And that's a chicken, isn't it?
No, looks like chicken. It's marvellous what they can do nowadays, isn't it? I mean, that corn gets stuck right down your throat. There's my old stocking, right? See that? I've hung that up on the wall. Even though that old corn stuck all the moisture out of my mouth, I don't care. And that's beautiful. That's what I'm trying to say.
I went into a crowded room the other day, and I said, yourself!
Well, you know, my friend Cherie. Oh,
there's a blade of grass.
Look at that, get that. That they aren't like at home.
Yeah.
You know, my friend Cherie, you know, the one with the
hips.
Yeah, the problem. She actually. She knew a woman who met a man in Scotland.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, that's not the weird part. Now, they met, they fell in love, she brings him back, gets him a green card, they're living together, and then the horrible truth.
What's that?
She finds out he's an otter.
Holy hole in a donut!
Yes, and I mean not just one otter, several otters who can manipulate themselves in groups to form the shape of a Scottish man.
I'm gonna barf!
I know, it's eerie, it's eerie. There are some pretty twisted people in this town.
And otters, too.
Oh, tell me about it. Oh, look, there's a guy naked.
Is there anything you want to ask, Buller?
How many people now are involved in Bullerism?
It started off very small. But now that we're up to maybe 5 people, including yourself, we're going right up into the sixes. You're obviously going to go my way, aren't you?
I need to know.
Because that. I wouldn't like to think that you've come banging on my plot, and you've got into my little scene, and then you're going to go the other way. No. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm trying to be nice. Don't get me wrong. It wasn't so long ago, right? I'd have someone in this cell. Coming in my manner, as I'd say it. I mean, I'll bit a man's ear off for less. I'm trying to be nice, but I can't go naughty. Don't think I'm an ice cream just because I'm doing the joystick treatment, all right? Because I'm liable to lose it. See how relaxing that is?
And, you know, sometimes the wing comes unstuck and attaches itself to the hair, sort of between your inner thigh and, like, the edge of your pants. Good evening. Tonight's main headlines.
Which would you rather have cut off? Your legs or your balls?
My balls, I think.
Okay. How about Tuesday?
Can't do Tuesday.
But Friday.
Okay. Yes.
When you can't finish anything, you have to be very careful what you say. I was in the travel agent. I put the word country at the end of a sentence. And they threw me out.
So there I was, waiting for the 253. And this charming old lady turned to me and said, When I go, I'll join Bill. We were married for 45 years. So I said, why wait? And you know, Jay, as the 253 approached, I nudged her lovingly into its path. I wonder whether they'll be reunited. You're an angel.
How can I help?
Well, I've developed a tendency, Doctor.
What's that then?
I'm a woman who wanks.
Well, that's not unusual.
In fact, it's become a compulsive obsession.
Has it?
Oh, yes. I'm completely crazed with it. I'm even doing it now.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
But I can see your hands.
Exactly. That's how good I've become.
So, what can I do to help?
Oh, nothing in particular. I just like to tell people.
I went up to a Grand Prix the other day, and I said, yourself.
This is
We are the Tomorrow Boys.
CDs, tapes, floppy disks, they're so archaic and dense. I can hardly hold them, they're so massive.
The whole kind of buy a record, take it home and listen to it thing, that's dead.
Yeah, we're experimenting with releasing music biologically. We're putting stuff in yogurt. We've released stuff in certain types of soup, corn.
We're actually releasing our latest album, Soil Science, as a cold virus.
Soil Science has taken us about 6 months to make, but it's been released now on our own label, Cultural Chaos. Most of the sounds are carried by this sort of low-grade flu infection, but there's also some hepatitis in there for the low end, just to beef it up a bit. You can experience a couple of tracks from the album by infecting yourself at one of the contagion points that we've got set up in most high street record shops.
It's weird. There's definitely sort of GABA going through my legs and big beat in my shoulders. It's not like listening to music. It's like my head is jungle.
Everything's merging together like a chord.
It's like my head is this ball of ears.
It's a completely subversive revolution. I mean, every time someone who's carrying Soil Science sneezes or coughs, they're passing on a whole new perspective. We're infecting politicians, beggars, school children. It's going to be massive, and there's nothing anyone can do about it.
Of course, when the forklift truck was invented, forks were a lot heavier than they are now.
Next. Stand on the mark. Name. To camera.
Tommy. Tommy Booger. Little Tommy Booger.
Right, Tommy, you're here for the part of Simon, the very handsome young chauffeur of Lady Marchmaine. And what piece are you going to do for me?
Today, Mr. Queer, I am going to be Dad's Army. Are you listening, Wilson? Stupid Wilson. Stupid Wilson. Jones, you stupid Jones, you stupid Jones. Pike, you stupid boy, you stupid Pike.
Thank you.
Well, you know what it's like when you've had a few beers. I just saw him stood in the garden, ran up to him, says, come here, you, give him a great big kiss.
You trying to piss?
No, I just...
Because if you're trying to show off in front of people, I'll take you for a walk, all right? You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, I'm a lovely guy, right? But I've still got friends, all right? I've got a little friend in my pocket, Uncle Stanley. Right? If you'd like me to introduce you to him, that's not a problem. Love ya.
Some of them are so long. If I'm wearing a very tight T-shirt, you can actually see them poking out the top of my bra. Good evening. Jack Lemon.
And when can I receive it? Monday. Very good. My name. Okay, listen carefully. It's Sheson Adefumilayo Osuko Pipa Otimba Fera Fera Oreze Shineke Smith. My number is 0171-50, as in Hawaii 50. Pa 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 pa. Sis, as in sis that man. 3, as in that tree is going to fall on your head. 2, as in to your room now. 8, as in if I have to count to 8. 8, as in I said if you allow me to reach 8. Extension 999, as in emergency.
I was a lifeguard for a little while. Terribly tragic.
I'm sorry to call you in at such short notice, Mrs. Dawson, but the situation here has escalated regarding your son Rocky's behaviour in school. It pains me to tell you this, Mrs. Dawson, but his attitude is appalling. He causes nothing but trouble both in the playground and the classroom. It states in his report here that he's a thief, a bully, a liar. He's split up friends, brothers, lovers, mothers and others. He's committed acts of arsony, drug dealing, causing an affray, possession of a deadly weapon with intent to kill, fraud and a number of other crimes I daren't even mention. Now, I can't possibly understand where this behaviour stems from, Mrs. Dawson.
Well, how the fucking hell should I know? I mean, he's sodding off half the time, and the other half am at bleeding work. He's a spitting image of his father, and he was a useless two-bob prick.
I'm not sure whether I like your tone of voice, Mrs. Dawson.
Well, I certainly don't. I sound like a fucking geezer.
And the father is?
Luckily for you, he's doing time. Otherwise, he'd be down here smashing your poxy mush apart.
Quite. I believe the way of moving forward in helping young Rocky, Mrs. Dawson, is for you and I to work very closely with one another. That may mean spending a couple of evenings together. Maybe. Or a well-prepared lunch in a quiet little bistro somewhere, perhaps. Come to think of it, I've got 2 tickets for the Covent Garden Opera House this Saturday night. No one to go with. Do you enjoy the opera?
No.
Well, would you care to join me? It'd give us plenty of time to discuss young Rocky's future.
Fuck it. Yeah, why not?
Well, I'll pick you up at 8. I'll be in a taxi. We'll probably want a drink or two.
Yep, sounds all right.
So, Mrs. Dawson, or can I call you Elaine?
Call me what you like.
Oh, please, do call me George. Oh, Elaine, I must confess. The moment you walked through that door, I knew we were meant to be together. Me up here in the office, you downstairs in the corridors mopping. You're the most beautiful creature I've ever seen. Shall we dance?
Yeah, I think we ought to.
Just the two of us. We can make it if we try.
The word bomb, that's a useful word, isn't it? Because you can say like, oh look, there's a bomb, like that. Or rather, oh my god, there's a bomb, more like. Or you can use it if you forget the words to a song. So for example, you can sing, fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Bomb, 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 Jupiter and Mars, if you can help it. But what you cannot do is do that if you forget the words to a story. So, for example, what you cannot do is say, and so Little Red Riding Hood went off into the forest to see her grandmother. Bomb, 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 bomb. The door.
My God, his head is completely grown back.
Do you know why we crawled out of the primordial slime? It was so that we could work in offices. How we've evolved. It's all been so worthwhile.
I just want to go out there. I want to help people. I want to do seminars for inmates. I want to do schools. I want them to know what bullerhood is like. I want them to find themselves. I used to spend hours just chucking prison guards over the balcony. Now I just sit here chanting. Nice to be nice. Which actually, if you slowed that down, actually you're saying, nice to be nice. Can you leave me on my own now? I've got to do a little bit of meditation.
When I'm gone, why don't you cut off my head and use it as an ashtray?
So, Mrs. Thistlethwaite, what can I do for you?
Well, I'm not entirely sure where to begin. You see, I have a problem, but it is rather, Monsieur Bumbaclat, difficult to explain.
I understand. Just try and explain it as best you can.
Well, that's just it, you see. I can't, because, to be honest, Miss Morgulica sent a million and make me feel airy. Me don't know what the problem is.
Right. You have absolutely no idea whatsoever?
No.
So how do you know you have one?
Well, you see, I tend to get in trouble rather a lot of blows and skirt your ass.
I beg your pardon?
Monsieur, blows and skirt your ass. Monsieur, kiss me black ass.
Mrs. Thistlethwaite, please, there's no need for that sort of
thing. Oh, you call Mrs. Thistlethwaite. Me not call Mrs. Thistlethwaite. Me call Mrs. I and I, Jai Rastafari, and me listen to the reggae music and thing, you know.
Mrs. Thistlethwaite, Mrs. I and I. I do believe I know what your problem is.
Problem? Me not got a problem, Monsieur. Me boss up your white tanky. Now, where was I?
I mean, have you seen Jerry Springer? I wish I'd never fucking bothered.
Nana, I wish I could go out and see the world. I am 22, after all.
Oh, you're not old enough yet, little one. Promise me you'll never leave the cottage. It's dangerous to go out onto the moors before you're old enough. Now, what about making us both some lovely warming porridge?
But we can't. There's a serious problem with the ob.
Oh, what's that, little one?
It is filthy dirty.
Then we'll have to get a young lad to scrub it for us.
Another one. Another youth. Oh, Nana.
Oh, yes. I'll just ring the job centre. That was quick. Oh, just what we need. This way, please.
Good night, sleep tight, and remember, tomorrow will be even less real than today. Exciting, isn't it?
There's more where that came from. That's at 12:05 next Friday night on BBC Two. Stay with us now, though. Music from Jules Holland and guests next tonight.